Hi, I'm John the Engineer, bank fighter extraordinary, bank protester, anti-bank picketer, and this is the sign that Barack Obama saw today. The other side is the Millennium Declaration resolution for an interest-free Unilets bank. And this was a big double sign that I could open up like this into a huge monster. And on the inside were my old standbys from my Jubilee 2000 days trying to forgive debt, which is don't cancel debt growth, abolish interest rates. And the other side was my United Nations sign to the religious summit, which was Jesus, Muhammad, Nehemiah say, do not lend money at interest. So these were the signs I was flashing for Obama, which he, I hope, could not fail to see. Canada's Globe and Mail, 10th of August, 1981. Every Thursday afternoon, as the Bank of Canada is pondering how much to push up interest rates, the latest brother combination of Canadian politics pickets the bank's palatial headquarters across from Parliament Hill. John Turmel, the interim leader of the Ontario Social Credit Party, says that if he were allowed 5 minutes alone with the central bank's computer, he could wipe out inflation. And in the tradition of SoCred founder Major C.H. Douglas, he's devised a system of equations that he says show that interest rates cause inflation. He is bringing the word P is equal to 1 over 1 plus R. R was the accountant's interest in those days I used. And U is R over 1 over P plus R. To the voters of Toronto's Spadina by-election as an independent candidate, while at the same time passing out his literature on the Spark Street Mall. So the first people who brought purchasing power equation and the unemployment equation published it, Globe and Mail. Good for them. The miracle equation, R over P plus R, now I over P plus I. John, who describes himself as a professional gambler and control systems engineer, says the government should establish a commission of control systems engineers to investigate the banks. Everyone else has had a chance to run the economy, why not control systems engineers? And there is a picture of me in a big box from an old fridge. And it said, why wait for 60% protest Thursdays, high noon? Interest rates were 22% at that time, and Pierre Trudeau had lifted the limit from 6% to 60%. I was known as a protester against banks with my equation in the Ottawa area. And here we are picketing, opening a parliament in Toronto, abolish interest, and the Bible says let the exacting of interest stop, Nehemiah 5:10, and that line's been deleted from some of the newest Bibles. Check them out if that's there. Here we are picketing in Winnipeg where someone didn't like us and attacked us, but there's my R over 1 plus R miracle equation in the background. And here we are picketing Vancouver, Bank of Canada, and picketing Bank of Canada in Calgary. And here it is with the chasing Prime Minister around. And of course, we were trusted because we are protest instructors. We want to do something. We have a suggestion. We don't want to hurt anybody. So, and here we are, of course, picketing with Mrs. Metcalf on Parliament Hill against Prince Charles, trying to bring her plight to his attention, with Pierre Trudeau really mad in the background. And my favorite of all is me protesting the IMF World Bank and getting arrested in the days before the 100,000 people, in the days when I was all alone with my banker's starved third world baby sign. So I was trusted in the Ottawa area by security, so much so that when the Queen came to town, I was permitted to, with my brother, with our picket signs, to get into her receiving line, even if we were the third line back. And I'm sure that's the first time that anyone's ever been close enough to the Queen to bop her with a sign, you know, because we were trusted not to be flakes. So that's why when Ronald Reagan came to town, here I am, I had already gone to the, getting ready to go protest acid rain and all that with my umbrella full of holes. And as I'm driving downtown, I have my protest sign on my back through town. I hear Ronald Reagan's going to be leaving, you know, the Prime Minister's office to go over to the National Arts Center, and there's people demonstrating and stuff. So I pull over, drive down, hop out, put on my hat, get out there with my picket sign. You know, abolish interest rates and bankers are crooks probably. And I start wandering down Queen Street and I come out at the cenotaph and everything's blocked off and quiet. And I've gone through a few police cordons, you know, and
but nothing's going on. And I wander right out into the middle of the intersection of Elgin and Queen. And, you know, I look down on my right, down a block away, and there are the barricades with all the communists and their big red Marxist flags going on. And I look in the other direction, and here comes the motorcade. So I wander right out in the middle of the road. And as Ronnie and Pierre go by, I stoop down at my side. I give them a wave as they go by. So I got to do that. So then I pop back into my car and drive over. I hear the media center are over at the hotel. So I pop on over, and they noticed an article from On the Hill. Helmut Schmidt, François Mitterrand, Pierre Trudeau weren't the only one people lobbying for lower interest rates during the summit. John Turmel was there too. Mind you, Turmel, erstwhile Ottawa mayoral candidate and interim leader of the Social Credit Party of Ontario, didn't get a chance to make his pitch directly to President U.S. Ronald Reagan. Well, they don't know about me with the sign a few minutes earlier, do they? So he did the next best thing. Wearing his trademark white hard hat and a broad smile, Turmel crashed the White House Press Center, temporarily established in the Skyline Hotel, and distributed literature. Despite his earnest manner, Turmel's missionary work won few converts among the American correspondents. TV news anchorman Peter Jennings, attracted by Turmel's noisy sales pitch, turned and regarded this apparition in a hard hat with distaste. "Who's that?" he demanded. Informed of Turmel's identity, he asked, "How'd he get in here?" We could only hope Pierre and the boys were more persuasive with Ronnie. Well, security finally came by and said, "Where's your pass?" And I said, "Geez, I don't know. I went past all those cops. I didn't say anything, so they put me in." When Gorbachev came to town, that was really funny. He was at the Cenotaph, and I was across the street on Wellington Street, and with my big picket sign again. And when it's over, he gets back into his limo, and he's coming around. I'm going, "Oh boy, he's going to drive right in front of us down over to Parliament Hill." And as he's coming by, his car stops right there, and he gets out and he comes by and shakes people's hand while I'm standing there. So I've had interesting exposures to world leaders in that sense. So now here comes Obama to town, and I have my signs ready to go, and I show up on Parliament Hill, and here are a few clips from what happened. So here I am wandering along the front of Wellington Street, introducing myself to security. You see, the old guys there, if you remember.
Okay. Google for a YouTube photographer.
No, I hadn't seen you on TV. I hadn't seen you on TV or on Auto lately.
That's
so
right. Yes.
How long ago did you move?
5 years.
Yeah. I'm going to go for the conveyor belt switch, which is why I come. I'm a protest obstructor. I tell people what.
All right, now flip it. All right, now half and half, just to show the versatility. Flip it. Flip, whoop. Flip it, and then fold it, and then flip it. And then flip it.
This was a Guinness record needle point. I joked that I had one too.
Canada. Here, get this one. This is why.
With everybody being taxed, so when Obama got there, he had to have seen the guy with the white hard hat out in that big middle of expanse of snow with that big sign reaching 10 foot high for sure, which let him know that there was a solution he could adopt. The Millennium Resolution C6. And all he had to do was go to King of the Poppers at YouTube and see how it could be done. It was a mission that paid off. It was fun, but it's incredible how studiously the TV cameras had to work to avoid this pink elephant in the middle of the place with this big sign, so they could always have tight shots of people without me in them, even though my mom told me she saw me 3 times on one channel from afar, but never did they ever focus in to see what this pink elephant was about with the big picket sign. But it did get mentioned by Christina Spencer, a reporter for the Sun Canoe Network in Canada. Everyone loves a visitor on the February 19th, overlooking Parliament Hill. Visits from world leaders bring all sorts of people to the Hill. Well, I've gone to the Hill so many times for world leaders, yes. For instance, perennial political candidate John Turmel, who has run for office 69 times. I'm running now, you know, I registered. Was out campaigning and touting his website, which he didn't tell them. Sorry, eh? Too bad, eh? What a help that would have been. He's a professional gambler and says he's got lots of poker tips there, too. Yeah, and she didn't tell you where, did she? Oh, well. So there were signs urging the U.S. to withdraw. Other things, goodbye. So Canada's interest rate protester, anti-bank picketer, has picketed Obama and given a message that interest-free banking is a must. And who knows if word will ever get back, but who knows how many pictures were taken, how many videos were taken, and who will be checking out the information on how to engineer heaven out of what's now our hell of a mess.